I'm here in Vegas, and let me tell you guys, everyone here is talking to me about Cotto Gamboa, how it doesn't make sense, how there are weight classes in boxing, and why won't Cotto fight the meat? Why won't Cotto fight Demetrius Andrade, boo-boo? Why won't he fight Gabe Rosado? Why won't he fight Brandon Rios? The fight was offered there. Rios is ready. Rios is willing. Rios would actually win that fight. Instead, Cotto's going after a much smaller fighter in Gamboa. Gamboa is about 5'2", his best years, 130. Also fought at 35 once. But why is Cotto fighting him? Cotto fought at 40, 47, 54, even 60, won a championship. He should be going after the 54 fighters and giving the real fighters in his weight class the opportunity. You're going against a smaller guy. Yeah, it could be an interesting fight. Gamboa is a hell of a boxer, but not take anything away from Gamboa. Olympic gold medalist. But the size, their weight class is for a reason. Fighters at 140 should fight people at 140. People who light heavyweight should fight light heavyweight at 160, 154. Cotto was saying that Triple G is too big for him at 160. But Gamboa's not too small for him at 135, at 130. So the fight may end up on TV in December. It will be interesting if it happens. I don't understand this latest trend in boxing. Fighters should stick to their zip code. One weight class under, one weight class over their weight class. But not three, four weight classes under. Or it just becomes like a circus because we always see the bigger man wins. Now, if one of these fights happen and in a crazy thing, Gamboa knocks Cotto out, then that's a shocker and the whole world will be talking about it. But what are the chances of that? Cotto was talking to Marquez, but there was a weight issue, a money issue. Cotto was talking to Brandon Rios. Brandon was down for that fight. Brandon still wants that fight and he's ready for that fight. So stay tuned. We'll see what happens. But what's your guys' take on this? Cotto against Gamboa. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Elise Ekback reporting.